Hey everyone, welcome back to Podcast Reno number 37.
Jesus Christ.
Patrice Bergeron's jersey number.
As my old English teacher, math teacher would say, pitter patter, let's get at her.
That's also
Letterkenny. He's got that weird like actor Drew voice and he needs to go back to class.
just give him a slap or something.
Yeah, where's normal Drew? We want him back.
Remind Rob not to be a teacher.
My favorite.
Last week's comments compared with give him a slap.
If you're too old, it's just weird, man.
My favorite comment from last week's podcast was, imagine Rob with kids while he's streaming. The toddler would be playing on and with the empty cans on his desk.
Oh, they're still there, unfortunately.
Oh my God.
That'd be awesome.
What? I thought I logged in the other day and they were off.
No, they're there.
No?
They're going to be there.
I'm going to message your mom this week.
Yeah.
If they're not out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, me too.
I'm serious.
They're like... How was there
I'm
not,
semi-serious.
There's going to be fruit flies, blah, blah, blah.
If I just like put a thing on your front door being like, hi, Robert's mom, can you please get him to clean his desk?
Here's
Thank
the
you.
Thing.
Concerned viewer.
Concerned viewer.
If they were full cans and they were just a selection of your faves, I kind of get it.
But they're just like half drank.
They're not half. They're like three quarters.
Oh, you're right. That's so much better.
Some of them,
I feel like if they were empty and cleaned out, that would also be better. I just know they're not. I know you drink one and put it there.
Don't they genuinely like smell bad?
Like my setup literally smells like Doritos and like stale beer and ciders.
That's gross.
But, all right, Rob, tomorrow, when we're playing Among Us, if I see cans on your desk, I'm going to message your mom while we're streaming.
Yeah, and
I'm going to release the footage
of around this house. That's all I'm going to say.
Just leave
he leaves
everyone
lots
guessing.
Of drinks around the house, too.
Yeah,
fine.
That's it.
I'll mull it over. How's that sound? Get
no.
it?
No.
I'll mull it over.
All right, Drew, your comment.
He just admitted to having a mullet.
I'll mull it over.
Shout out my boy Fruity Pebbles. VG would most likely... I'm going to paraphrase here just because yours didn't quite make sense.
Well, I'm making this one. I'm butchering this kid. Sorry.
VG is most likely to fake being gay to get into a girl's sleepover.
I'm pretty sure we saw that one like a few weeks ago, didn't we? That one sounds so familiar.
Yeah, but I think it's because like day one we brought that into group chat.
Is that all it takes?
Maybe. I think it's relevant every week. So
mine is from DJS. Rob has a child. And it comes out as a bag of Pro Time powder.
Pro Time?
He put Pro Time in protein.
It doesn't mean protein.
I think this guy is your child.
Yeah. He wants protein powder but can't spell?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, I have two. So first night, Blacklight FTW, video number 7 of me commenting about the sign of the shelf changing. I am finally losing my mind because no
sign?
One else mentioned it. We noticed it. It took, 8 videos. This was that was the 7th time you commented.
I don't know what Rob's talking about.
I have no idea.
The sign.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, these.
The displays?
Yeah, they're new displays.
No.
Display.com.
He said he comments every time about the letters changing.
What There's letters? No letters on there.
No.
The displays have literally changes. Been the same
Fucking
for the past.
Sign.
Rob, we don't know what you're talking about. There is no sign.
I don't get it.
You guys are fucking with
the
me.
The displays have been the same for like, I don't even know how many
podcasts. Move on. Next comment.
All right, next
this
comment.
This sign
next
that
comment.
You just set up with
next
the letters
comment.
On it.
I don't know what
next
you're talking
comment.
About. Next comment.
Next comment.
Are you guys...
What?
Watch
next
your hat.
Comment.
My brain hurts.
That's normal. Next comment.
Okay.
Because you said you had two, right?
Yes. Rob, I'm a speed demon. Also, Rob. I can't go over 60 in my Corolla.
That's great,
that's
though.
Good.
Yeah, that's fair.
All right, so, Rob, right before we started the podcast, you're talking about how you watched It for the first time last night and how much of a pussy bitch you are.
That's not what
and
I
also
said.
No, that's my words. Also, I did not realize how much of a pussy bitch you guys were.
Yeah,
they agreed with me.
I watched it.
Yeah, but you said you got scared.
No, I didn't.
Oh, never mind. You're good.
But it was... Okay, so it's like...
I got scared by Scary Movie, though.
I finished playing COD at, like... No, I was playing Fall Guys yesterday. Got my second win, as
Get
I told you guys.
Street.
Fuck you.
And I was like, you know what? I feel like watching a movie. I didn't really know what movie I wanted to watch. Again, I wanted to watch Lord of the Rings, but I forgot that they're like 3 hours, and it was 12:30 on a... I almost said school night, on a work night.
if you feel like watching Lord of the Rings on a work night, you just got to suck it up and watch it.
I know, I debated it, but then I would have been up till like 4.
Isn't it like 2.5 hours?
I skipped parts of it.
Okay. The scary parts.
Yeah. So like, I was like, you know what? I haven't watched a scary movie in forever. I'll just fucking send it and see what happens. I ordered it and like half hour in, like the scene where like the kid goes to get his like paper.
Wait.
I can just drop spoilers, right?
Yeah. Because that was literally every trailer.
Yeah.
It too is out.
Yeah, but
pretty sure you can drop spoilers about it.
Okay, that makes me feel better.
Question quickly: you said you ordered it.
Yeah, it was on. It's on Rogers on Demand.
Did you pay for it?
Like,
it must be on Netflix.
$3.99 or something.
It's on Netflix.
I don't have Netflix at the moment. The person whose account I was using. He hasn't
had a girlfriend in a while to steal from. We'll give him a pass.
That's unfortunate. That's the unfortunate truth.
And his friend group split him off.
Yeah. Well, I literally have never paid for Netflix and have had three different accounts. I consider that almost like a life skill.
My man.
But
that's fair.
Anyways, you're watching it.
You put that on the resume?
I've never paid
for Netflix.
That'd be a cover sheet thing, actually, if anything.
It's in your bio.
So I never saw, like, that scene's in the trailer, right? Never saw how it ended, like with that kid reaching his arm in. Didn't realize the clown fucking mouth opens up like a fucking alligator with like teeth and just rips the arm right off. I was like, okay.
He eats him.
It's going to be one of those movies. And then I skipped ahead a bit because it was getting really intense. There was lots of like tension and stuff like that. And then the scene that did me in was like the clown, like he's like stalking this one girl and he like grabs a girl and like lifts her up. And like the clown's mouth like opens like sideways and up and there's like rows and rows of teeth and like tons of yellow lights in his throat. I literally paused the movie and turned on all the lights and stood up. I literally went for a walk, dude. I was like,
really?
I was like, yo, I can't do it. Well, the thing is, I've never been a horror like connoisseur. I've never exposed myself to horror movies as a kid. Mm-hmm. The first time I watched a horror movie, the first time I watched a horror movie start to finish was in first year university when I was 19. Mm-hmm. Yeah, whatever, same thing. And that was Paranormal Activity. So I went straight into the scary shit. But the thing for me about horror movies is that like they stick with me, man. Even like all of last night, I was like, I may or may not have slept with the light on.
What scares you?
Just don't stick your hand in a sewer grate and you're good.
Well, what scares me really is the dark, because you don't, when it's you in the dark, man, you like your brain has like it. I don't know about you guys. My brain works against me. It makes me think I'm hearing shit.
Like clothes hooks.
You know who? Yeah. You know who can relate to that? This guy. This guy's brain is so fucking scattered.
I hate it, man.
We'll just be in conversation and be like, yo, my laptop. I need to go get it. And he's just gone. He's gone. He's somewhere else. And then he comes right back and then he's gone.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I assume he can relate.
Drew's brain's like a solar system with each planet's a separate thought. And the sun's his brain, you know?
I'm on Saturn right now. What'd you say?
I'm on Uranus.
You're basically just scared of the dark.
Well, I'm kind of. The movie like accelerated that because like in the movie, the clown's always like creeping around the corner or in the dark. And the one thing I've always like hated is, you know how there's like pictures that like their eyes will follow mm-hmm. you.
Yeah.
Like in the movie, they like literally has just even, you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
There's like a old painting in this person's house that the kid is absolutely terrified of, and the eyes start to follow it. The thing jumps out of the painting and fucking eats the kid. And the kid just cuts to the scene and the kid's body just like lying on the ground seizing up all this fucking painting.
He doesn't eat
eating
him.
It. Yeah, it is. It's like he's taking bites out of his neck and face.
I thought that kid survived. I can't remember the movie too well.
No,
he got eaten, bro.
He's gone.
Yep. He got his ass eaten.
Next time you see him is in the basement when he's just getting eaten. A little raincoat. Yeah.
Yeah.
What? No, the raincoat kid is the one from the sewer.
Yeah, that gets eaten.
And no, but he's talking about the Jewish kid
who gets eaten by the portrait.
I'm pretty
monster
sure. No, he doesn't get eaten. I'm pretty sure he runs away and like cries to his dad.
Well, the scene that like it's literally the fucking creature from the painting bent over the kid, biting his face and neck and shit. So if he's alive, then
he survived. He survived.
He survived. Whatever.
Oh, maybe that's why.
But
how do you survive that?
Well, I don't know. I skipped that scene, so I don't know how it turned out.
Rob's the type of person to skip all the scary parts and at the end be like, I don't fucking get this story. Yeah, man.
That's kind of what happened because I was like, what the fuck
Rob
happened?
Rob pays $5 to see a movie, watches half of it.
I watched probably 50 minutes of it in total.
Nice.
Okay. But, so two things.
Okay.
First is like unrelated to what you're saying, but about it. Do you guys know what the original ending of that movie is?
No.
It's like a weird that's another thing I Googled after. Apparently that there's like a really weird mm-hmm. pedophiliac
it's not pedophilia.
It's like all the kids doing something together, isn't it?
Yeah, that's not pedophilia.
Well, it's still fucked.
Have you watched the movie, Shane?
No.
Okay, so basically there's like one girl in it who her reputation on the school is like being the slut, even though she's never had sex.
And they're all like 13.
It's just like she does it to pretend to be popular.
They're all like 13,
all the kids that she hangs out with.
I'm telling you.
All the kids she hangs out with are like the losers and nerds.
Mm-hmm.
And then in the original story, after they kill the clown, Pennywise, they go and have, like, it's supposed to be like a coming of age story where they all, like, have group sex and all fuck the girl, like, take turns.
Wow.
And then apparently Stephen King, after he wrote like, recently was just like, yeah, I really regret writing that. I don't know why I did.
Yeah.
Probably when he was fucked out of his mind, but they did not include that in the movie, surprisingly.
That's like thank fuck.
That's like a therapy session from a boy, Steve. Oh, man. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that guy's...
Also, in the movie, don't they, like, all cut their hands?
Yeah, they do, like, the
So is that act. Supposed to, like...
Instead of the orgy, it's them, like, shaking hands with blood and shit.
Nice.
And then the second part I wanted to say was, as, like, a not armchair, you know, therapist, psychologist, whatever, you know, the reason why, like, you hear so much in the dark is because when it's, like, bright and stuff, you're on your computer, you have headphones on, you're distracted, you're on your phone. But if you're just lying in the dark, you're going to notice these things that already happen while you're normally doing stuff. You just don't hear it because you're not focused on
it. But my imagination, like that too, but my imagination, it's like, I'm scared that if I look to my right, I'm going to see glowing clown eyes and shit. You know what I mean? That's the shit that fucks with me.
I don't mean this as a chirp, but it's going to come off.
It's going to be a chirp.
When I was 10.
Jesus.
I watched Scary Movie.
Like the comedy one.
There was nothing funny when I watched
it. It's literally in the title, Rob. Scary Movie.
Yeah.
It's scary. Fuck do I know. There's like 7 of them. They're all terrifying.
Yeah.
And just for some reason... But my friends, like, previously had made me watch The Ring, where the chick just crawls out of the TV.
Yeah, fuck
that. That one I'll say is a bit creepy.
And that was terrifying. I couldn't look at TVs. And then so I'm watching Scary Movie.
Which is really bad for a kid with ADD.
I stopped watching TV. I had to go outside. It was really traumatic.
Traumatizing as a kid.
Mm-hmm. And then Scary Movie. She starts crawling out of the TV. I'm pretty sure I just locked myself in my room for like a week after seeing that.
Nice.
Yeah.
But again, I was 10.
That's kind of where I was at. I was like... Last night was like, fuck, dude, I'm not going. And like, I literally had all the lights in my basement. I was like going upstairs at like a couple stairs at a time, being like, you know, like this, because I can't. It's fucked. I can't turn the lights off at the top of the stairs, only the bottom. So I have to turn them off at the bottom. And fucking sprint.
Oh, and Pennywise just grabs at your legs.
Literally. Well,
and he's just like, come clean those cans.
when his face like opens up and bites your legs off and shit.
So I like IPAs.
Yeah.
This is gonna sound like a chirp, but it's not.
Okay.
So after we watched 11. After we watched it, Annie also got very scared and was like,
so it's normal.
No, it's not.
She's your older
being
me.
An asshole, and so in the movie, like, he has huge amount of teeth and would smile like really large. So I would start smiling at Annie. I don't normally open my mouth to like show my teeth, but I'd intentionally smile with my teeth. And she's just like, she'd start like screaming, like, no, get away from me.
That's perfect.
So and the actor himself is like a 6'8" like Swedish dude, and he after the movie he was just like, I feel so shitty after filming that because I was just fucking with these kids the whole time. Like I was reading, like, I watched a YouTube video about it after.
Did they actually keep the kids scared?
And the director wouldn't show, he wouldn't let the clown and the kids like correspond or see each other on the set because they wanted each time to be like a fresh go at it.
Yeah. Jeez. So the kids were actually fucking terrified of this thing.
That's pretty savage, fucked.
Man. Yeah.
Because most movies, like horror movies, they'll make it where like the villain or horror person or whatever has to interact with the crew in order to not like mentally fuck them.
Yeah,
well, no, those kids are done.
And those kids, like, you can see like in the scenes, those kids are fucking terrible, just like me, man. They're fucking like shaking and huddling, and when the clown comes up and like does shit to them, they're like jumping back and stuff. I mean, too,
they must be getting paid pretty well because they all came back for round 2.
Yeah.
Oh, 100%. Well,
I thought round 2 was all adults, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, but no,
but they grew up. The kids grew up.
I guess they could have filmed those before.
They waited 40 years. Yeah. Like, no,
they were dedicated to that shit.
They have like flashback scenes of them being kids, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, I haven't watched the second one. But I'm not gonna. I personally have just
that
never.
Might be a lie.
It might be just because I'm more of a media person, so like I see, I'm like, oh, I see like the editing, the makeup stuff that they did, and I understand how they did it.
I don't give a shit about any of that.
So like I can see something like that, and I just dissect it, and I know it's not real.
It's like for me, it's like I don't. You know what goes on behind, like, you know, special effects. Like you're probably my buddy who is taking film,
okay,
and like Drew. we'll watch a Star Wars movie or something. He's just like, you know, they could have done a better job with the After Effects and blah, blah, blah.
No,
and I'm like, dude, like, fuck off. I'm trying to get immersed in this movie. I'm not trying to think of the fact that that's an actual movie and actors and shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I feel the same. I just watch the movie. I don't care about the...
I don't give a fuck about the effects. I don't care about...
One thing that confuses me, though, Rob, is... So, like, how do you... You get so invested in the movies, but you're not the same with video games. You're very detached from video games.
Like,
why?
Well, shooters and stuff, I... like. games like Far Cry, I'd get right into. Mm-hmm. Far Cry, Skyrim, like the Outlast games. Like the Outlast games, like, and retroactively, I went back, Outlast 1 looks kind of like ass. But at the time when I was playing it, I was like, I'm literally playing as the person in the mm-hmm. game. You feel super immersed.
There's only a few like that. Like, great. Yeah. Like, they have to pull you in. Like, Skyrim's perfect.
Skyrim, yeah. Skyrim pulled me right in.
Grand Theft Auto, when we first did the story.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Great story.
But games like Siege, COD.
Yeah, there's no...
Games that I like, where you need to understand the mechanics of the game to be good at it, that's when you can start to notice stuff that differentiates.
And that's why I love games like RimWorld. Where you get attached to a character and then watch it snatched away from your life. That's why I think Red Dead did so well. Because you get so attached to like the main character and all of a sudden they're gone. And you're like, what the fuck?
I'm really worried for the day Shane has kids. It's like, get really attached to this game, he's just going to be gone.
Like, once he hits, what, 18, 20?
Empty nester.
See
Yeah. Nah, even like
I can play RimWorld again.
Even like Destiny, I got really into because it was like, Destiny is like my exact type of game. You know, it's kind of like you're in like,
it was pretty sweet.
The cosmos, or whatever the fuck you want, space, I guess. And like, you're like some, you can make yourself into a fucking like tank. I made like a hunter. Just like, I don't know, being like a space cowboy is kind of like my ideal game. So like being on, playing Destiny was sick because there's like tons of different planets you can do. It's like all open world.
Then shouldn't your favorite TV show ever be Westworld?
Yeah.
It is up there. My favorite
is, it's actually amazing.
My favorite is The Mandalorian because it's like, I can sit and watch Mandalorian. Like, I've literally watched it all the way through 3 times just because I just think the show's like that good.
Mm-hmm.
The first time I watched it, I was watching it like week by week. Second time, I wanted to watch it all in like 2 days. And then third time, I was just like, you know what? Do I want to start a new show or watch Mandalorian again? No brainer.
Or watch that JP something.
Oh, HP Lovecraft?
HP Lovecraft.
So the HP Lovecraft show is actually good. It's an episode 3.
In one gaming session, Rob mentioned the show 6 times, and every single time he mentioned it, he's like, have you heard about this show by HP Lovecraft?
Yeah, I was
like,
hyped about it.
Which Rob, you've told me the same story 3 times.
It's called Lovecraft Country. It's the new HBO show. It's the guy. It's directed by the guy who made Get Out and Us. Michael Peel or something?
The dude from New Girl has a new cartoon, and it's freaking hilarious.
Yes. Which guy from New Girl?
Schmidt and Nick.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Hmm. It's so funny. Bree's brother was watching it the other day.
What's it called?
I don't know. That's why I was wondering.
It's like a Family Guy type show and shit?
Yeah, kind of. Kind of like Family Guy, BoJack. It's like definitely an adult cartoon, but so funny.
I don't know. The only cartoon show I've ever found funny is Family Guy. Just because it's just so crude. Like, I don't know. Simpsons
Family Guy and sometimes South Park.
Oh, South Park. What am I even saying? South Park is fucking hilarious.
And Happy Tree Friends.
No, that shit was too like...
Just, I hated that show.
It just was visceral, bro.
It was so weird.
Yeah.
It was so unnecessarily graphic.
Yeah. I had a nightmare about that.
Is it called Hoops?
Yeah. It's about a basketball team.
Rob would love just the photo on the cover.
Yes, sir.
A naked man on a school desk with a basketball.
It's really funny.
Is it like on Crave or something? HBO?
No, I think Netflix.
Oh.
No idea.
You know what is definitely on HBO? Netflix. A show called Lovecraft or something?
Oh, funny.
How do you have HBO but not... Isn't HBO really expensive?
It's
parents have it.
True.
We have the...
They don't know they're paying for it.
We bought the like package from, again, Rogers that has like the Crave mobile app. It's like $47 a month.
Jesus.
It's pretty fucked. But like you have
I need to cancel mine when it's 30 a month.
Because it works
Crave
for...
Crave is not that expensive.
Well, it's like we have everything. It works on the Rogers boxes, on our phones, Chromecast.
You can only get HBO now through Crave.
Yeah.
So you have to bundle them. So you have to buy Crave and then you get HBO, which is like an extra $20 on top of that per month.
And then there's tiers to it also.
Yeah.
The base tier, you don't get any new releases. So like Lovecraft Country, you don't get... And seasons 7 and 8 of Game of Thrones, you don't get. Mandalorian, you don't get. All you really get the basic one is like stuff they've had for ages, like The Sopranos and shit.
Which I didn't even know there was tiers anymore.
You definitely got Mandalorian.
I tried to watch it the first time around.
Not the new one, maybe?
No, like the entire season was behind the second level paywall.
I definitely watched Mandalorian on base Crave at some point.
Maybe when it first came out, but after the fact, like I know for a fact because I would have just stayed in the normal one, but I literally bought it just to watch The Mandalorian.
That's why I was so confused about the pricing.
Mandalorian's on Disney Plus.
That's what it is. Disney Plus. I have Disney Plus.
I had Disney Plus for 2 months. I literally bought it, watched Mandalorian twice, watched like all the new Disney Star Wars as once.
Yeah, and then just got rid of it. Cancel it considering you have to spend like $30 to watch Mulan.
Yeah, it's fucked.
Yeah, a lot of people were complaining about that.
It's dumb.
On top of that, like with HBO, people were complaining saying it's the only service where like you can look something up and it'll be like, oh yeah, it's available, and you go to look at it and it's just like, no, you gotta pay for it.
You have to pay for more.
Yeah.
It's so stupid. It's like,
wow.
And the fact that Crave just sort of bought HBO and you can't watch it anywhere else except for that.
And yeah, like, it just sucks.
My days of trying to like find like, you know, Put Locker versions of stuff are just done because they really fucked my old laptop up. That's yeah. for sure.
Well, wait, Crave didn't buy like the company, right? They just bought like the
distribution. They bought the rights to it. Okay. Because HBO is probably bigger than Crave, I would imagine.
Yeah, I can't imagine Crave just
maybe,
buying
maybe
HBO.
It was just probably just Canada, I would imagine.
Maybe HBO bought Crave.
Because I know HBO had...
maybe, like, actually. Who knows?
No,
could be. They had their own app, but then I think they canceled it for Crave, so probably they just didn't want to handle it. And they're
I remember Crave first came out, and I'm like, who the fuck's going to buy this when Netflix and shit's out? And then all of a sudden, they have HBO. And I'm
probably like, Apple and Hulu.
Dude, they made so much money during the last Game of Thrones season, though, because that's when they first did their deal, was Crave and HBO like launched with Season 8 of Game of Thrones.
Mm. Yeah.
So I remember that's when we first got it. But then... Let me watch Chernobyl. I want to watch Watchmen, I think it's called. That, like, they kind of like comic book series. I think that looks going to be.
Oh, they made a TV series?
Yeah.
It's really
good. I heard about the movie like 15 years ago.
I've heard mixed reviews about the TV show. I watched the first episode, liked it.
Just didn't go back, though. Just never got around to it.
Don't know why I didn't go back, but yeah.
The best HBO show by far is Silicon Valley.
I haven't seen an episode.
Pretty jokes. I heard the older seasons are kind of trash, though.
No, I think it, like, continuously is like pretty great throughout.
Would you say Silicon Valley is better than Game of Thrones? Though it's kind of hard to, it's hard to compare them because they're such different subject.
I would say it's hard, because like I would watch Silicon Valley again, but it's a comedy.
Yeah,
I'm not watching Game of Thrones again.
Like Game of Thrones is a story.
The
like,
older
you know
seasons
what it
are
is.
Pretty
well,
sick,
like,
though.
Why?
What?
Why wouldn't you watch Game of Thrones again?
I have no interest.
I have I know what happens.
I know what happens, and I have no interest.
What happens in Silicon Valley?
Yeah, but it's a comedy, so like I'll laugh at the jokes again.
I'll watch Harry Potter again. I'm not going to watch Game of Thrones again.
I'd watch Harry Potter. I'd watch Game of Thrones again, though, to be honest. I'd watch specifically season 6, probably, with like Battle of the Bastards and shit.
Yeah. I'll just go through all the fight scenes.
Yeah.
And the incest.
I still hated Battle of the Bastards.
My favorite part.
Okay.
You hated Battle of the Bastards? Why?
Because Jon Snow should have died.
Nah.
That was the most fan, like, pandering scene ever. He literally is, like, being crushed to death by thousands of people. He's just like,
but he's the chosen one, dude. He's Azor Ahai.
He just fucking jumps up. Like,
yeah.
He should have died.
Azor Ahai, dude. He's the chosen one. He has to survive. There's just that guiding force to just his destiny, bro.
Yeah.
Nah.
He's like the dude of fire or light, whatever.
Yeah, the guy who
just gets revived every 2 seconds.
Mm-hmm. Till he didn't.
Yeah, till he didn't.
Unlucky.
And then he came back.
Nope.
Jon Snow?
No, the guy with the fire sword.
Oh, Sir fucking Beric.
Yeah. Sir
Fire
Sword.
That guy fucking loved fire, dude.
Your boy died.
Yeah. Well, even he stayed alive way longer than he should have in that scene in season 8. He gets fucking shanked like 1,000 times.
Yeah.
And then he just, like, oh, I'm still alive, but fucking.
There was so much of that,
well,
though,
season
in
eight
the
was
last
pretty,
two
season
seasons.
Season 8 was really fucked for that.
But, like, by the end, you're talking like you're with the toughest of the tough people.
Yeah.
Like, I get you got stabbed 3 times, but people can do that.
Like the Hound.
Have you
and
ever
shit.
Seen people, like, coked out of their mind? You can do a lot of things.
Get shot, like, 6 times, they're still running around.
You don't know what they did. They cut those scenes out. They don't want you to see
those. Crackhead energy, bro. It's a real thing.
Yeah.
Other than Battle of the Bastards, the worst scene I saw was the one in season 8 where it's, like, the army is like storming what's it called,
like King's Landing?
No, the like Jon Snow's place.
The dead army of the dead.
Yeah, dead are raiding Winterfell, and then like it does like the pan over view when all
the
like zombies are attacking, and it's just like each person has hundreds of people dead underneath them, and they're just like slashing and killing hundreds of people all
at
once.
Thing.
Like
really? I was quite okay with all of that. I was, because again, you're talking the, like, you now, the armies are
these
dead.
These people are fucking,
these
like,
are,
yeah.
like, the craziest fighters to be in
Sir
the realms.
Jorah and shit.
Yeah, they're literally the best fighters, like, in existence. Except for the one guy that should have died episode, the first one he was introduced.
Sam. Yeah.
They're panning through, and he's just, like, huddled and, like, stabbing. I'm like, this guy should have died 15 fucking episodes ago.
Yeah, that's one thing I'll test
and
God. One character I always fucking hated with a passion was his girlfriend's name. Or
both. Gilly or something. Yeah.
No.
I hated
Gilly.
Her. She did not do anything except piss me off. She was just dumb.
She should have stayed with the freaking family in the forest.
She was just there as a crutch for Sam, bro, the entire time.
My God. You know how he was like sacrificing kids?
Yeah.
I wish they sacrificed her at the beginning.
Sam's probably like, here, take this kid and my fucking
annoying
ass girlfriend, bro.
Blanca, holy
God.
What? I hated her character,
That whole storyline
storyline just killed me. Why? It was cool that he like healed Jorah or whatever. That part, but he should have fucking died 30 times.
Like, it says, go, Sam, we gotta do this. I hated her voice, dude. It's like, fuck, bro.
The one girl,
I agree, I hate them.
The one girl in the entire show who's supposed to be like portrayed as ugly, Rob's like, I fucking hate her. Every other girl who's supposed to be portrayed as hot, he's like,
here's the thing, she could have been hot and I still would have hated her.
Well, if her voice was like that fucked, like, close your eyes and listen to it. It just made me fucking think of like a fucking witch telling me she's gonna kill my family.
That's how I felt about Sam.
Well, Sam, I didn't mind Sam.
Dude,
but
should have died so many times.
I liked him, and he peaked for me in the middle, like season 5 or 6, and then like 7 and 8, I was like, dude, get this guy off my screen.
Exactly.
Bro. I don't want to hear. Have
send him back to the chapel. To get him out of here. Get him back to the library.
See,
we don't
that's
want
how
him
I
here.
Felt with Jon Snow.
No.
After like season 5, I was just like, he's run his course. He's such a boring character.
He was pretty boring, but again, like he was sick.
I just love hate John, the bro. Idea of like the chosen one. I prefer fair. When it's just like this is the like a character who actually is surviving because of his merit. And this, it's like, he's not even that great.
Disclaimer: big fan of Bran being the king.
Yeah. This, oh yeah. It's the same people thought Bran had the best story.
No, he didn't have the best story for sure.
I said that it made the most logical sense, which it does. Would you choose some random person who can let emotion?
No, you choose the
judgment.
Guy who has literally no emotion.
You choose the guy who literally communicates through a fucking raven going into his brain, bro.
Yeah.
That's not
well,
how
Bran
works,
is but... a warg. Bran has seen everything. He knows the past, the present, the future, blah, blah, blah.
Okay, Rob.
I just think it's like, if you were cheap, my king would have been Tyrion.
Okay, but Jon Snow surviving was cheap.
Tyrion.
That was just like a, okay, like just but let him so
and
survive.
And it was lore?
No, but like,
thank you.
You have to decide either you hate the like plot armor or you love it. You can't.
I love.
You can't
die. Jon Snow survived. Fucking,
I hate
I love
Sansa.
Then you have to like that Bran was the king.
Sansa, her growth was.
Her growth.
No, she went from.
Rob.
Oh no.
She went from annoying to like trying too hard. Too annoying to like you're just overshadowed.
She was fucking
by
queen.
Everyone.
She was the queen of Winterfell, bro.
She was not
she
overshadowed.
Was fit, she was not fit to rule.
Yeah, she was.
Yes, she was.
Nah.
She was fit to rule.
Jon Snow should have died.
No.
I just again we'll circle back. We've talked about this many times. You
Ned
have like,
Stark should have lived.
You have like 7 or 8 people at the end that you can choose from. You pick the one that maybe might be the most logical, but is just the most boring.
But that's literally what Game of Thrones is. Always been
correct. The one thing that pissed me off too is you built up like what Cersei and Jaime. You built them up for 8 fucking seasons.
Yeah, that was pretty bad.
To have like this like massive ending, and then just a building collapses on them.
And then if they had moved 10 feet to the right,
they're
free. Alive.
They're gone. Yeah.
No,
because Tyrion comes down and he like there's a pile
of
rubble
standing
right
on
there,
like top of all the rubble.
Here's the thing: the room they were in, like you could see the fucking exit. They were right there. They just like hung up for a second, like oh,
we might as well die. Fuck.
Yeah.
Well, no, because the exit.
I know it.
Not to mention, Jaime got stabbed like 4 times by fucking that Sea Lord guy, whatever the fuck
good.
His name is.
He'll just get a gold liver. It's fine.
Yeah, he'll get a gold hand, a gold liver.
I
he'll
also
see a 3PO by the time the show's done.
There was that whole scene where Arya goes over to that place where like has the massive army. You pay for they only got like 3 seconds and they got their ass beat
the Golden Company or the Unsullied which
no
ones?
The Golden Company
the guys who are the ones who were supposed to be there to hold the city and then
they showed up for 3 seconds and then they just bailed.
They had that pussy ass guy at the
pansy
ass.
There's so many
I don't
things.
Even remember that
in the sand snake people
the
wanted
Dornish.
To see more of them didn't give any.
I would love to see like
really a lot of
those, like,
people a lot of people hated that. That was like a very common complaint in the
community
that they hated the sand people.
I hated it because they gave us like
it was a tease, bro.
They gave us like 15 minutes of it.
Yeah.
You gave us like they literally killed the ruler. Like there would have been like a power vacuum, their whole fucking civilization would have been fucked.
Yeah.
No. They just cut that part out. They kill someone on a boat. And that's it.
They had a vice ruler that just took over. It was all pretty civil.
Well, there was still lots of bloodshed.
Fuck.
All I remember from the sand people is that they, like the 3 sisters or whatever.
Yeah.
One of them was really
so
hot. Yeah. The one that would pull their stuff out for, who was it in the prison? It was
Sarah. That was the one with short hair. The other one I found way more attractive.
The one that was short hair I found really hot, but the other one was also hot too. Mm-hmm. They were like some of the hottest characters in the whole show. Mm-hmm. Not gonna lie. Mm-hmm.
10 out of 10.
Now, what's her face?
Daenerys?
Marge? Or no?
Marjorie? She was also really hot.
Dude, that was the only time that I actually cared about someone dying in the show.
When they blew up the whole thing.
And it was so funny.
Christian cries.
Me and Annie were watching it. And like, because that whole episode, I did not see it coming.
It was sick.
But I was... I'm the worst person to watch stuff with because I was telling Annie, I was like, this is about to happen. I know it's about to happen. And then I was like, okay, she's about to die. And then when we were watching, what's his name, Tommen?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
How were you not sad when Tommen died?
That part was fucking
laughed my ass off. He just because jumps off the side of the building. We were watching it, and then I told Annie, I was just like, he's going to jump out the window. And she's like, no, he won't. Like, that's not going to happen. He puts on the crown while he walks away. I was like, he's going to jump out the window. She's like, no, it's not going to happen. And he just fucking jumps out.
That scene was so perfect.
Here's the part. Like, that part is, like, it's fucking sad. Like, if you think of the whole backstory, it's a kid thrown into power. His whole fucking city blows up. And he kills himself.
Yeah.
Literally, like, statutory raped by...
Yeah, it's fucked.
Queen.
Yeah. But then when you watch the scene, it just doesn't... It doesn't know justice. He just puts the crown down. He's trying to build up, like, all this sad. And it's just like...
The thing for me is like there's no music. It's just focused on the windowsill. Yeah. And Tom is just chilling there. You can see him kind of chilling. He's like, fuck. Takes the crown off.
Yeah.
Jumps. And I hear someone yells at the bottom.
Yeah.
The whole scene was sick when like they're chasing the kids who are starting the fire thing underneath the thing. And like
that was pretty cool.
That was a really cool scene. And then like the kid like slices that fucking loser's leg, whatever his name was. Lancel or something?
Yeah. Holy fuck, that guy pissed me off.
That guy pissed me off but, so
like,
much.
He was like put in to piss you off.
Yeah.
I think fair. So anyway.
I say that he was like a character early on who comes back just to piss you off.
I love it because his character early on was kind of like normal.
He's a little bitch. Like he would just run around and grab everything for people.
Correct, but... And then he comes back and he's like a fucking...
Rob's like takes on everything person. Is my favorite thing in the
he's
world.
He's not wrong.
He is. Like Robert Baratheon would just be like, fuck you, little boy. Bring me my ale. You
don't you think it's really creepy that there was like a 40-year-old man in the same scene with like a 17-year-old boy?
It makes my skin crawl when I think about it too much.
You know what's crazy too is to think of
you
like...
You guys just took a sip in sync, by the way.
Is to think of like season 1 and 2. Like think of those stories. Like think of what was going on and then think of like 7 and 8. They're like completely different fucking shows.
Yeah.
Like 1 and 2, they're like marching on the city, like Ned dies, like the whole thing gets fucked up.
Yeah.
And 7 and 8, like it's like
there's a how giant, far they actually there's a went. Zombie dragon attacking fucking and shit. It's fucked.
It's insane. Like that part's cool.
Yeah.
The whole time winter is coming.
Yeah.
Winter is here.
I think I now agree. I think I would watch it, but from like the beginning.
Yeah,
I watched getting like rehyped for it.
No, I watched it the entire way through. It was so worth
and
it.
And I'll pull a Rob. All the scenes with Sam getting the fucking fast forward.
I literally skipped over as soon as Gilly got into the show. I skipped over almost. I've already seen it. I'm like, I know she just says some stupid shit, and then it's next scene. Yeah. Skip the 5 minutes.
She should have been booted when they brought her back to the wall.
She should have been fucking sent out to feed the walkers, bro.
You know what's fucked? If you watch the entire series again, I did the math. I can't remember what
actual... I watched the whole thing back to back.
...number was, is that the intro is like 2 minutes long. Mm-hmm. So if you watch the entire series back to back and watch the intro every single time, it's like 6 hours.
The issue,
5 hours
the issue
that you spend
is,
sitting there.
Like,
the
there's
intro.
A button to skip the intro.
But the issue is
but you don't do that.
You have to listen to that intro.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
that song.
Well, you
there's
have
something
to
about it.
And it gives a nice little recap.
And you can see everywhere quick sprint, take a piss, quick
grab,
sprint.
Get something to eat.
Yeah.
Well, it's like the intro slightly changes per season, too. Very slightly.
Per episode. Mm-hmm.
Does it?
Yeah. It depends on like what happens. Because if there's an episode where like one of the cities falls, in the next episode, it won't
the
be there.
The first time I noticed that was when the first season happened.
In
and
season 8.
Changed. No, in like, season like 3 different. When they go to Bravo with that giant statue there. You see that in the intro. I'm like... They're changing
the best one again is when they
fucking hell I didn't realize till now
the best one
I
is
caught on
is when they blow up like the church because like the next intro
it's
it
just
goes there and
smoldering poof. Pile
yeah it's sweet
awesome. I want to know what the intro budget was
probably more than some shows that we fucking watch
no
probably more than like the shows like the fucking Good Doctor and shit
if that's a decent show
that.
Too
really you think it's a good show The no. Good Doctor? You know what show we're talking about?
When I said decent, I mean dumpstery.
Every single show that CTV has an ad for, this looks
it's,
like shit,
it's
dude.
Bad, man.
No, I didn't mind it.
Well, it's just like...
The guy's such a good actor.
It's a guy from Bates Motel, right? But he's playing someone with like a disability.
autism.
We're treading carefully here. Just I don't want to say anything.
The show's premise is about a doctor with autism.
Yeah, but
you
like,
can say
why fucking, couldn't they just find someone with autism? Well, why did he have to act? They could have just found
just
someone.
It's just such an odd show, dude. And apparently, it gives him like superpowers and shit.
Chris is just like
the guy's doing his surgery, and all of a sudden he's X-ray vision. He knows exactly how to fix everything.
That's not. We've talked about this. That's not actually what happens. It's just so you can see what he thinks.
Yeah. I don't know, man.
It's like in 21 Jump Street when they're high and they're all like tripping out. Like,
yeah,
you're not actually. Yeah, it's like, shit. Yes, they were. You're like, taking mushrooms between.
It's like, dude, this guy, he has a disability. He's not a part of the fucking X-Men. You know what I mean? Like,
but it's just a graphic to show you. It's not how he sees it.
That's the only thing I saw was me walking by, and it's like a scene of him going, like, ooh, and like, all of a sudden has X-ray vision. Okay,
so you haven't even watched the show. You just walked by for one scene, and you're judging the entire show and all of the premises all based
needed,
off
to be
all
fair, all the commercials are fucking trash.
So, Rob, how do you feel about Suits?
I never watched it.
How do you feel about wearing suits?
I hate them.
Yeah. I hate them because you wear them.
So the Suits' whole premise is the guy has photographic memory. And he'll, like, it'll show pictures of him looking at documents he's seen. But, like, they don't actually see documents in their head. They just know what they read.
I need to watch Suits.
The
to
one
form
season.
It's like the same thing where it's, like, a graphic overlay being like, oh, this is how he sees it.
Here's
but
you don't need that shit. Yeah. I watched one season of Big Brother, okay? And the guy who won had a photographic memory. And you think every time he was fucking taking pictures, they were like, oh, let's put some fucking graphics in here.
Yeah.
No, they just like ran it through and he fucking dummied everyone.
Yeah. Fuck, man. It's that easy. It's that fucking easy,
you
bro.
You have to tap the temple. It's the photo button.
There's not like a fucking
some guy's just like
overlay that pops up.
Exactly. You don't need it. I know he can. I know he's taking pictures. Look at him focus. You know what he's like focusing
me,
in.
What this reminds me of.
Macro lens.
Yeah.
Is when Drew, I don't remember if you were here, Rob. I think Shane was. Where Drew was telling, I think it was my sister, how he thinks in black and white. He doesn't think in colors.
No.
Or like
no.
You don't
they
see.
They said, "What color do you? What
the
color
fuck?
Do you see
a
when you
fucking
close your
dog?"
Eyes?
No, it was like we were talking about like what you see when you're thinking of stuff, because we were talking about how some people they don't think of visions when they think. They think of like words.
This is I was gonna say. There's a thing. You either think
that's actually a thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
People,
so either
people think in shapes.
That'd
like,
be
it,
the
it,
worst.
It goes crazy.
Oh, I'd be like seeing words. And I'm like. This is spelt wrong. Everything's spelt
it's
wrong.
Like for, it's someone, for example, I've seen a YouTube video on it. Someone, like, people say dog. Someone sees a dog in their head. Someone sees D-O-G.
I see the, like, physical.
I see a dog. Like, I see a golden retriever.
And so we were talking about
like
this.
I can't give an accurate thing because I don't know what I'm, like, I'm thinking
about.
And
Rob, dog. When we were talking about it, my sister was also talking about how people, some people can't see in color in their, like, head. They see
that's
just
strange.
Black and white. Or they see, like, in only a few colors. I remember when we were talking about it, Drew was just like, I think I'm like that. And we're like,
but
I don't remember this.
Keep in mind.
It was during cooking.
He's colorblind, so he's missing a color.
True. Mm-hmm.
So like, he's like, okay, I can see in color, but really he's only really seeing black and white.
It's just a projection.
Oh, yeah, yeah. He thinks he sees color. He thinks he knows color.
Quick tangent.
I know color. That's purple.
It's green, Drew.
That is purple indeed.
Quick tangent. Among Us, we were playing one time and Shane was like trying to accuse someone of murder, and
I panicked,
it was like Danielle was light blue and she died, and so when it comes up to the screen it shows who's dead, and Shane's just like
Danielle did it.
And then we're like, Danielle's dead, like this is literally why we called the meeting, she's dead. And then he's like, oh, it's doggo was orange. And he's just like, I saw like the color, I don't know what it was. I was like, Shane, how fucking colorblind are you?
It turned out to be doggo, so I was fine. But doggo was not happy about it. He was.
You got it right on a fluke.
He was okay. So I saw someone pop out of a vent, like on the far side of my screen. Their name was cut off, and I just fucking sprinted it because you can go to like the kitchen table to press the emergency button. I'm sprinting, and then someone found a body, and so I'm still mid panic, running from the fucking killer. And anyway,
I knew how to play, but I was super excited.
Danielle and dog was always so it was just the D,
double D's.
Yeah.
Anyway.
The only remotely thing close to what you're talking about is I came over one day and your sister and you were swimming in the pool, and she asked me if I like when I close my eyes if I see black and white or something else.
Okay.
And I said that I like see black with like colored specks.
Yeah,
that's what I said.
Oh yeah,
too.
And that
and
we said that
thought,
was weird.
Everyone
like
thought
the,
that was a hot take.
It's like the aurora
we were talking
borealis.
About either you see color or you see black and white, and you're like, I see black and white with some color sprinkled.
When I close my eyes, like, you see like things fucking floating around. No. There's, there's like a light bulb over here.
We weren't talking about
colored static.
We weren't talking about like physically eyes closed. We were talking about like what you see in your head when you think. So that's why she's like, close your eyes, think of something. So you
she literally like, close your eyes. Do you see like black and white or color? And I'm like, well, I see some speckles with purple.
Maybe she didn't explain it well, but we were talking about what you were thinking, not like what you see in your mind.
No, I see in color.
Okay.
Do you ever like go to
but
like
when
fall
I close
asleep?
My eyes, it's like static.
That's everyone.
Do you ever go to like fall asleep?
That's
and
why
like
I was
as
like,
you're
what
laying
do you mean?
There,
that's
all I see is just circles.
Or and like
my
every
vision,
once in a while, like I'll be laying there and I'm like halfway asleep, and like it'll be like a fireworks show.
Yeah.
And then that's like, how I fall asleep.
It's like kind of kaleidoscopy.
Yeah.
Just like,
but in my mind, I'm thinking like fireworks, and it's a
fucking
trip.
The worst thing to ever do is if you're ever laying like on a chair outside or something, and you're looking at the sky. And you can see, like, if it's a clear sky, all blue, you can see the, like, wiggly things that are in your eyeballs.
Yeah, yeah, I do
like,
that. That's bad, though.
Yeah.
Well, isn't that bad?
That's like,
that
when right. I go they, to that... look like fucking, like, refrigerator coils in this
yeah.
part of your
Like, vision. it's just dirty stuff in your eye, and you're only seeing it because it's on a blank
slate. When I go to the doctors, or the eye doctors, they're like, hey, like, if you see anything floating around, or see any, like, light spots, that's bad. A squiggly is a floating. I think
but
they
I
mean,
don't
like,
see it all the
spots.
Time. I only ever see it when I'm like looking at the sky. Just
yeah, I know what you mean. The sides of them, your eyes.
Have
are
you
like
ever
all...
been to the eye doctor and they just put that light and you can see the tissue at the back of your
yeah.
eye?
Yeah,
it's orange and like red and looks. Really...
I've like, not
dude, what
seen
the
that.
Fuck is back there, man?
Yeah,
oh, pull my shit out of
I
my
go
head.
To the university because then they do all
yeah,
these like crazy tests.
They fucking put like lights in the back this? Of your eyes
yeah,
and
yeah.
shit, and like literally like the back of your eye. Like they, I don't know what it is. Some part back there just looks like a fucking like desert or something.
It is
that's
weird.
The best way
probably
I can explain
it's
a skin
like fucking
pocket
Mars.
Back there.
Looks like Mars.
Looks like Uranus, bro.
No.
You said Uranus.
Okay, you guys were gonna tell a story about
Catan.
Okay.
Oh, I forgot about that.
I'm interested
and why
to hear.
We hate Amanda now.
Okay.
So
she's not watching.
Is she, is she canceled?
So pretty much in summary, Annie and Amanda. Both...
Well, you have to give context of the first game.
Yeah, but
this is the context.
In summary.
This is the context.
In summary, because of the first game,
both. In summary, they both retired.
Nothing wrong.
Shut the fuck up. Okay. In summary, they both retired. They're done. They don't want to play. They're going to play.
Take
they
them off
the
Excel
play.
Sheet.
True.
And he has no wins.
Oh. Just like in Fall
we
Guys?
We can sanction her if she doesn't play a sanctioned event.
Just, yeah, yeah. Just drop, just drop her to D2. You
know what do I mean? We know it's what true. The word sanction means? I feel like we just kind of throw it in there.
Sanction means a flotation device. Keeps you above water.
Yeah, exactly.
Exactly right.
True. Anyways,
yeah. So like they're like rules put in place.
No, you guys are dumb if you don't know what it means.
So anyways,
I feel like Rob's the author of Urban Dictionary. I don't know what it means. I'm just gonna make some shit.
What
up.
Is a moose knuckle?
Oh. Okay. Anyways, so that
the
first
of the
at
hoof.
The end of the first game. Me and Drew Christian was gonna win, and the only way I could have won is if you maybe rolled a 7. That was my only chance. So I made a trade with Drew that was trading pretty much my deck.
With not. Oh, yeah.
It was for Drew. With my deck for his deck because we do like a point system. So I could gain a point. He could gain a point. Amanda. What? Despise this.
Can I stop?
So basically again? They were trading like Shane was trading like 4 cards.
Yeah.
For Drew's 1 card.
No,
because,
two.
No,
or two cards.
Two. Yeah.
Because the 2 cards would give Shane an extra point. And then the 4 cards would give Drew an extra point.
Here's the thing. Shane would have had no clue that those cards would give me a point, though. He was just getting... It was 3 or and a
wheat. Which makes it worse, because I was just giving you my fucking deck for a couple cards.
Makes it better.
No, it makes it worse.
No, it makes it worse, because it makes it seem like he's throwing.
I just don't care.
It
makes
I'm
it better.
Throwing. So no, regardless...
He gave me 3 or and a wheat.
Okay.
So
and I had no other wheat, because I had been looking for wheat for like 3 times.
This part doesn't matter. You got an extra point. That's all that matters.
Yeah,
but
Amanda was pissed because she was trying to trade with me, and I said no, because you would give me an extra point.
Is that move viewed as BS?
But
very much so.
It's basically like, imagine if you're in like a tournament style, and the two people in last are like, oh, like, let's just give each other points so we can go up the ladder.
And like, it's we'll have to put something in play. Like, I don't like it either. I don't like playing for points. I'd rather play... To play the game, I'd kill
why
the whole
on Excel sheets
just to keep track. I would kill the whole Excel sheet to not have that happen again. That's a whole other subject.
Here's the thing. I got.
I don't care. Anyway, so
over
Drew,
so many
Drew
times
ties
on that Excel
shut
sheet.
Up. Drew then ties Amanda, so that also rubs her the wrong way.
So she, like, Amanda was really pissed, being like, "You guys can't do this. Like, that's not allowed. It's against the rules."
So then, choose better spots.
Game two, game two happens.
Play the fucking game, right?
Game two happens, and we're like a turn or two in, and Niall has pretty much blocked Annie's one route of escape. She has one more. She's going towards the shore, and Niall's pretty much a turn away. Annie trades. She's like, Amanda's like, "Hey, I'll trade pretty much a road," and Annie's like, "Here's my whole hand."
So she was trading like five cards for two.
For two.
Just
so Annie could cut off Niall instead.
After being mad of us doing that.
So then me and Christian are like, "Whoa, would you look at this?"
Yeah. And then Amanda was just like, just trying to stay like stone face.
And then me and Christian, we didn't trade with Annie or Amanda the whole rest of the game. We
denounced them.
And then the best part is we somehow convinced Niall to join us.
No, it was the perfect thing because it was like me and Shane versus Annie and Amanda. And Shane's just like, "Niall, you can choose which side you want. Yeah. We're not going to force you." 2 seconds later, and I was like, "Shane, do you want to trade?" You're like, "Welcome to the team, buddy."
I can see Niall doing that.
So, to be fair, we're keeping out a lot of BM. Like, there was a lot of shit talking between there. We're roasting the hell out of them.
Also, the unfortunate part that I didn't realize is that Annie was outside while we were torching Amanda for that play.
Yeah, so she missed part of
it. So Annie had no idea that there was a lot of like shit thrown at each other.
So when
she came back and just did that, she's like, "Whatever, that's just what we do." And so when we threw shit at her, she's like,
she got personalized
and got really pissed off.
That's the thing too.
That makes it even better.
You have to. I think we're very, very good at it. I think you're good at it. We haven't played enough games at. Like, as soon as we walk away from the table, we'll roast each other for it.
Containing it in the game.
Oh, yeah. Like, playing COD or something. Yeah.
But there's many times where we're yelling at each other, or you're yelling at each other, or we're yelling at each other.
And at each other's throats.
Exactly. Like, and then afterwards, we're still chirping each other.
Yeah.
But
it's a different tone. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't think
that's what I tried to tell Annie. I was just like, I think the big issue is that she can't separate.
We're way too competitive.
She sees it as like, this is how we are.
A personal attack.
Whereas
it is a personal attack at the time.
Yeah. and that's what I told her. I was like, you need to like separate it. You need to just understand this is just a game and we don't actually mean it.
Just tell her.
And I was like, look at me and Drew. Like, we were literally about to kill each other at the table.
It was funny.
And then right after, like, okay, we're fine.
Just tell her.
Think about business and pleasure.
Like the octagon, you know, the UFC octagon.
Oh, yeah,
you go in there, you fucking just give her, and then you at the end of it, you dap your opponent up and you have a fucking cerveza.
Yeah, but holy smokes, like Amanda gave me the old, "I think I'm done. I think I'm retired."
No,
I agree.
You're not allowed
to retire. Of a game.
But so
great. I loved it.
So,
I won.
Oh, I loved it. Okay. He won both yesterday. Yeah, it feels bad. I also was thinking too, I feel like in baseball, Christian, you might not get this, but you know how in baseball everyone hates it because it's like old man sport. There's all these unwritten rules.
Yeah, it's like don't steal if you're up by two.
Yeah, or don't hit a grand slam when you're up seven.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, don't load the bases, then you're shitty.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Regardless, I feel like I broke an unwritten rule for sure. And then they followed up by breaking like the same unwritten rule. And because I was trying to explain to the man, I'm like, she's like, "Well, what could we have done?" I'm like, Annie could have been like, "Here, I'll offer you like these two cards for that." You would have probably taken it. She could have been like, "What if I toss in one extra?" She'd have to go, "Here's my whole fucking deck."
I didn't notice this, but what Annie claimed happened was that she said she offered to Amanda. She's like, "I'll give you an ore." And Amanda's like, "No." She's like, "I'll give you a wheat." She's like, "No, I need like a sheep or whatever." So then Annie's like, "Then I'll give you all of this." Because she didn't have either of the cards that Amanda wanted.
So what I'm hearing is Amanda should have known better.
So, okay, so sorry, to jump
and
into.
And this all falls on Amanda.
So to jump into, so that she had to pay her whole hand, right?
Yeah.
To get this one road towards the shore.
This was the best.
So then she only could build either like one or two. So I build like three roads out from the side and build right beside. So all that meant nothing. Yeah. She couldn't build anymore. And then that's when we're like, yeah, we're still not going to trade with you guys. Even though that you can't do anything.
Well, like, that's fair.
Yes and no. Again, unwritten rules were
Here's the thing.
Broken,
you guys do that shit to me all the time. So if you do it to them, that's
when,
fair.
When you guys left, she's like, "I felt like Drew."
Yeah, she did. Yeah.
There it is.
Drew got the so... What did Drew get mad in the first game, too? Oh, what did you do to me that I was so fucking pissed? I don't remember.
I traded with Christian something.
Yeah.
But you didn't like the trade.
Yeah, and I was pissed at you.
Yeah.
But then I traded you three turns
He's
later.
He's literally like, "Drew, I'm never trading with you again. I don't care how many times you play this game."
And then I gave him my whole fucking deck for two cards.
Literally, next turn gives me three ore and a wheat for, like, a sheep.
Yeah, anyway. Good times. I love it.
Yeah.
I love this.
See,
Rob,
this was your friend group that like just split up and they were playing Catan, they would not have survived the game.
There's dudes who still are like, don't talk to each other. Well, not like from way back when you used to like Rust 1v1s and shit. Mm-hmm. Those would get those would be like the loser. Like if you lost, you would just like leave the Xbox party and never come back.
Jeez, you got annexed.
Well, I remember I would just fucking I would BM because like
chill with the big words
and
small word.
The Rust 1v1s. Yeah, you guys played Modern Warfare 2.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
I know you guys probably. There's Intervention of the Barrett. I would always go for the Barrett route, one, because I felt more comfortable with it.
I can't
it.
Talk to you anymore.
And two, if I got close, I would just spam it and hip-fire the fuck out of people. So then everyone's always like, oh man, blah, blah, blah. You cheat all your 1v1s as you use the Barrett. And I'm like, I'll use the intervention and I'll fucking piss on you right here. And, and I did that to this one guy,
yeah.
And I haven't talked to him ever since. No. Although I beat him 20-6 with the intervention.
Yeah, so to be fair... You should never talk.
Yeah.
It's over.
A good thing he was just like an online friend, but like
you slapped him in the face. To be fair to him,
though, you shouldn't be using the Barrett.
Well,
but he said he went the other route.
Here, beat his ass. If you're listening, his gamer tag was Sharp Raccoons. I'm willing to have a
was
one
he, like,
last
referencing
one.
The teeth or the claws?
I have no idea. Maybe the raccoon they're as a whole smart. Is just sharp.
Yeah, they're smart.
Maybe
they're good looking.
Or
raccoons
sharp
are good looking.
Yeah, sharp dressed. But I beat him twice in a row with the Barrett.
They got the little face mask on.
And he's like, "You're a shit, dude. Use the intervention." I'm like. Right now.
Let's go.
Bang, bang, bang. 20-6. Leaves Xbox party, never comes back.
The best is those games, like, again, you literally played 26 rounds.
Yeah.
Like,
I was so fucking, like, I knew the mechanics of that game and said no. But just recently, I 1v1'd someone from, like, just Discord and stuff. Like, a guy, he plays on mouse and keyboard. He fucking destroyed me, dude. I'm not even kidding. We were trying to snipe in Modern Warfare, and I've never sniped in it. I only ever use a sniper in Warzone. Which is like, obviously I'm not quickscoping on Warzone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
This kid just fucking lit me up, dude. I haven't been destroyed like that in a while.
Well, it's because snipers don't really have too much aim assist.
Well, there's no, like, on especially mouse and keyboard, like, it's just you zoom in and you're right there.
Yeah.
Controller, and, like, it's like...
How does the aim assist work with bullet drop?
Like, I don't think...
Because, like, if it's 200 or 300 meters out, like, will it, like, auto-lock
to
their
head? I don't think it's vertical at all. It's just, like, the only aim assist I noticed is if someone...
Oh, aim assist. I thought you meant the bullet drops.
No.
I was like, where would it go? I was like, 500 meters, that's about a foot to the right.
It's like, if someone's, like... If I'm, like, ADS'd on a wall and someone runs in front of it, it'll, like, drag me to follow them a little bit. I won't, like, track them the whole way, but it'll, like, indicate someone's there and it'll follow.
So it's really hard for you to snipe really long because you have to, like, micro-bump
exactly,
up
because the auto-aim will... Or aim assist will like indicate where I need to track to, but it won't go up and down with the draw.
I used to love aim assist, like when I used to only play like Red Dead 1 online.
Yeah.
And it just snaps to people's like chests. Yeah. So on a remote, it's just like it snaps and it's just a flick of the thumb, they're dead.
Yeah.
Like headshot, boom. I'm riding around on my white fucking buffalo. Headshot, boom.
But
headshot, boom.
What I will say is like mouse and keyboard sniping is superior.
I just get destroyed.
But controller like regular
else.
Gun is just
because it doesn't require
use.
A skill at that point. You're just
like if you know how to jump shot on a controller, you can shit on anyone.
Mm-hmm.
But sniping on mouse and keyboard, I was like, damn, this is an astronomical difference between the two.
Yeah,
but I would love to see you try to play controller for Siege.
I don't
because
want
there's
to,
no
dude.
Aim assist.
There's none.
No,
really,
zero aim assist.
How do you lean?
You can only do it while you're aiming down sight.
And you have to like click in the stick or something?
Yeah, the stick, whatever way.
Shit.
But as soon as you unaim down sight, you just go
have
back.
You tried Caesar controller before?
A few times.
Did you like it? Well, obviously not.
Fucking garbage.
Who's the one who does? Priest?
Yeah.
He's the one who uses it.
Priest plays on controller?
No.
It's like half and half now. Like he's been moving a lot more over to mouse and keyboard because he's like, really? I've peaked in controller. Like I can't get any better because controllers are just limited.
Mm-hmm.
You can't really
like,
perform better.
Did he like start on controller?
Yeah, he's been controller for like 15 years.
Time and a half.
On Siege too?
Like, he always played, because he was
like
a console.
While he's making content and shit, he's been playing on controller this whole time?
Not all the time.
No.
Like, he's half and half, but, like,
sheesh.
Before, like, if a year ago, I think he would have been only controller. Like, now he's a lot more mouse and keyboard trying to get better.
That's fucked. I couldn't imagine playing Siege on a controller for that long.
Man, I try and, like, play Nazi Zombies when I have a buddy over. I mean, like, not anymore, but, like, when a buddy would come over.
He has no buddies.
Like, after the bar, a buddy would come over, you try and play, like, Zombies. And I'm just, like, turning around. I feel like a boomer just trying to play.
Yeah.
I can't really use controllers for, like, first-person shooters anymore.
The only shooter I play with a controller now is COD. And Halo, I guess, if I ever play it.
But you have a mouse and keyboard.
I'm just so used to the muscle memory of COD. Like
the only thing
I use
a controller for is like racing games.
Yeah, that'd be true. And Fall Guys.
Yeah, Fall Guys is the only one that requires that.
But
I'd say Rob,
it doesn't require it.
Or like to actually like consistently win and do well. Yeah.
I was.
Yeah, Bunny gets like 3 wins. He's like, yeah, I'm actually the best.
I'm at 10.
have zero. Shut up.
I have two. But I was debating on trying Warzone mouse and keyboard, but the thing is, there's so many other shit, so much shit you have to worry about, like drop shotting, like mantling, like mounting on stuff, your mantling, equipment.
Just
your
mouse button, drop shot, don't do it. Done.
I drop shot, like, that's all I do, though, is just drop shot and
hit fire. I had the most, like, mind-blowing experience watching you getting shit on when you drop shot, because I remember in CG used to be able to drop shot, and I fucking hated people who do that because it's such a pussy move. Because it requires no skill and you just get all the benefit. And then seeing Rob try to drop shot someone and the guy just fucking destroyed him.
I had a fucking Origin, a shotgun. So, like, I'm going to lose that anyways, close range.
But it was still just so nice to say. I was like, oh.
It's nice because with the MP5, you can kit it out to be, like, you can have a tac laser on it, all these crazy attachments. So you can, like, laser people from, like, 30 feet away with hipfire. So you just hipfire drop shot and you win every gunfight. This kid runs in with a fucking Origin 12, which is, like, an AA-12 shotgun, and just... I'm drop shotting him, so my head's right in front of his crosshair.
Boom.
He literally has to, like, hit like a fucking half. Like, his crosshair covers half his screen at that point.
So you're saying if you didn't drop shot, you would have had a better chance of.
If I jump shot at him, like this, like, because he's coming here. He's coming in. I drop shot in front of him. He's a free kill. If I jump shot, maybe he shoots me in the leg and I survive.
So you didn't even have to jump. If you just stood, you would have won.
Sort of. Well, like, if that's anything but a shotgun, I kill him.
The best thing in Siege was, like, watching you stream, and then, like, well, maybe not, but
it's up there.
But watching those streams, because there was a point where it was like this is every single person's drop shotting, like, this is fucking stupid, and, like, you refuse to. And then there was that point where they nerfed it. They put, like, a delay in the drop, right? Yeah. And you get in all these lobbies, and for, like, 2 weeks, you just fucking smacked. Because every single person's, like, slow motion drop, you're like, bitch.
And they made it where, like, you can't aim down sight. So people would, like, be, like, lasering, and they'd drop, and then just fucking bullets flying everywhere. It's like, oh.
Exactly. It was so funny, too, because, again, they're still trying to drop shot. Yeah. You clearly couldn't anymore.
They took it out of the game.
It's there, but it's just not good.
I'm happy they took that out, though, because it was such a pussy mechanic.
Well, drop shotting in Siege is way different. Or not way different, but, like, if you hit them once in the head, it's a one-shot headshot, isn't it?
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It's like, unless you're really good at it.
Shouldn't that put you at a disadvantage then, though?
That's what I'm saying. It's like, you should die quicker.
All you see is their head.
Well, it's because you're aiming at their head, and all of a sudden they're on the fucking ground.
Just be better.
Whereas, like, in COD, it's basically the same thing. Is like, you're just trying to minimize your hitbox by dropping while also maximizing how much you can hit them.
It's easier to kill noobs because they can't track as fast when they get drop shotted on. You can tell who's
it still doesn't make it a good thing. Well,
no, but it's like, it's easier to tell when you're playing against another good player, because chances are you're both drop shot and you end up being face to face.
Yeah.
Or if it's a noob, you drop shot and they just keep just fucking firing right above where, like, over your back, and it's just like,
I refuse to drop shot.
I refuse.
Again, I just got so used to it in Modern Warfare 2.
Doesn't make it any
I played
any better.
It. I drop shot in Modern Warfare 2, but I was also like 13.
So. UMP silence to stop and power. 3 shot kill it. Like, almost any range.
No, it was the AK, man.
It's Atar 21. That's my gun.
Yeah, the AK.
No, the AK in Modern Warfare 2 is pretty ass, low key.
No, it was good.
I don't know. It had a lot of kick on the iron sights.
You used a Barrett.
Don't argue with Rob in COD.
This is the COD pro. You're just a fucking wannabe.
When I was talking...
Dude, I spent 123 days of my life playing Call of Duty.
When I was talking to Rob about, like, the Call of Duties, what was it?
Exactly!
Spent almost 200... Anyway.
We were talking about the Call of Duties, and he's like, no, every single Black Ops has been amazing, like, 10 out of 10. Jeez. I was like, I'm pretty sure one of them was, like, widely received as negative. And then when Rob came in the chat, I was like, oh, perfect. Like, he reminded me. And I asked chat, and, like, everyone's just, like...
It was mixed.
There were so many people being like...
Well, the thing is, you're talking to your chat, and, like, they're very impressed. You presented it with a bit of bias on it. He's like, I thought most of the Black Ops were pretty trash, but what do you guys think? Blah, blah, blah.
And then all the kids in the back, like, just sucking them off. Yeah, VG, yeah!
Well, and then there's Bling. Rob's amazing.
Well, yeah. Rob's good. And then he just gets barraged by hate.
That's usually what happens.
Banned.
There's a couple dudes that have, like, they agreed. They were like, yeah, man, most of Black Ops are good. Some random dude just keeps adding me. He's like, dude, you're a fucking idiot. You know what the fuck you're talking about.
Okay, but Rob, what's more likely?
Okay.
That out of, like, the 1,000 people watching, every single one's just like, I'm going to fucking say whatever it is that he wants, or that most of them are probably just saying their own opinion.
But the way you presented it, like, you gave them the option to agree. Be like, yeah, I agree, this is shit.
Well, I said, I'm pretty sure I was like, I heard that one of or two of the Black Ops were pretty bad. I was like, I can't remember whether it was like 1, 2, 3, or 4. I just remember hearing that they were bad. And then I was like, do you guys think that any of them were bad, or which one would you say was the worst out of all?
Wouldn't
of them
Siege be like a main like competition with like a Black Ops type game?
Well, it's like Siege,
Black Ops, Black Ops type game.
Well, Siege, most people I find on Siege that I've ran into and talked about COD, they just think it's the worst game ever. They're anti-COD because
But you know what I mean.
Well, most people
feel like you play Siege or you play COD. I guess you could play both, but for the most part,
if you play both, you're going to be bad at one of them, like I am.
See, mm-hmm. I like Siege because I played COD growing up, but I always played Search and Destroy.
Because Siege is like way different than COD, bro.
Yeah, but it's not like a law where if you just play one, you have to be bad at the other.
You flip the coin. COD it is.
Okay, coming from someone whose KD is usually about 2.5 in COD. That's not a boost. We can look at my COD stats.
You use a controller.
Whatever. Still, there's other people on COD who don't have that high of a KD. You come to Siege.
There's three people.
And like... You value, like, in COD, I respawn, right? So I don't have that same value on my life per round.
True.
Siege, you have one shot. One opportunity. God damn. But, like, I don't know. Like, my point is, Siege, like, if you start on Siege, you're just kind of subliminally training yourself to value. Like, you don't have a respawn. You only have one shot. COD, it's like, oh, fuck. I can get go on a 5-kill streak, die. Go on a 6-kill streak, die.
I think what you're saying is that, like, some people will be like that, but you can't say like everyone.
No, it's not a blanket statement, but I think it's like pretty common that if you're used to running and gunning with an SMG and COD, it's hard to transfer over to Siege and carry that with you.
You just roam.
Well, if you're like I guess that's like where Ash mains and shit come from, and like
which are a plague on the community, and there's a lot of them. Oh, so
I don't know. I would be interested if in the comments if anyone's. Like can empathize with that if they came from COD to Siege and found it to be
Are there still actually a fuck ton of Ash mains?
Yeah.
I feel like I'd never see
the biggest Ash one is Jaeger. He has like a 95% pick rate. Oh,
yeah. Jesus. There's a Jaeger in every fucking game and he's just jumping out of windows.
His gadget isn't even that good, is it?
I played with... No, it's like one of the best guns.
Jumping out of windows, murdering my ass.
Losers,
no, it's still one of the best.
I mean, it's good.
ADS?
His ADS, amazing. His ability is amazing. His gun is amazing. His roam ability is amazing.
But like, how often does a Jaeger actually put down all of his ADSs?
All high ranks, all the time.
They literally put them all down, then they jump out a window and kill Rob.
Yeah, they spawn peek me and shit.
So like, they've already nerfed him like 3 times.
The fact
now.
He had an ACOG at one point just disgusts me.
Well, everyone had an ACOG back then. The SMG-11 had a fucking ACOG.
Really?
Yeah.
When did you take that sniper. Out?
Like, first year, second year.
The fuck?
But anyways,
it's like...
I was playing with Skittles the other day, who's, like, super fucking good at the game, and I was...
Smash it.
I asked him, I was like, if you had to look back on all your clips in the last 2 weeks, how many of them do you think would be on Jaeger? Because in the entire session we played like 3 hours. He played Jaeger every single round.
Jeez.
And then he's like, you can't put me on the spot like this, man. Like, what are you saying? And then he's like, I'd probably guess like 60, 70%. And then the next round, he chose someone else. He chose Womai, who's like Jaeger, but different.
Yeah.
And I was like, did I make you self-conscious about it? He's like, yeah, I can't pick Jaeger anymore. It made me feel like that's all I pick.
Womai is literally Jaeger, though, with an AUG. And like, basically. His ability is a little different. Like, I'd say
Whammy? He's basically the same, but
no.
Different.
Have a think about it. There's lots of ops that try to do what Jaeger does, like Womai, Mute, sort of.
Warden.
I guess. No. Wait, Warden? No.
Okay,
no. It's just anti-equipment.
Castle.
I guess Mute's not a good example.
Let's say Mute is
no.
Not.
Mute's like I don't know. There's
Castle can block grenades from going in the
I guess
doorway,
so, but like mm-hmm. Jaeger just destroys
wait,
shit.
Have you,
dude.
Am I wrong? Have you tried to throw a grenade at a castle wall?
Yeah.
You throw it under.
You can throw it under.
Yeah.
No, Rob can't aim like that.
So dude, I got a kill doing that. When I, the first time I ever played Nock, I remember it. I put
really?
A grenade under a castle wall and killed
being,
two people.
I remember oh being goodness. Sent a clip of Rob using some grenades, and it did not look like you were getting
well,
kills with them.
We can't.
Oh, yeah. The one I sent
bad,
the other
my bad.
Day.
You got a kill
yeah.
on yourself
yeah.
by throwing it at a wall, getting downed, and then... blowing yourself
I think
up.
I remember what clip that was.
It's the one I like clipped. You're like, you already fucking clipped that.
I'm always like, whenever something stupid happens, I'm just like,
dude, you literally like,
I look over and I'm just like, oh, it's already in Discord. Everyone's like, oh, you're so shit, bro.
This guy like peeks into the basement, gets lit up, walks out. He's like, I'm gonna charge a grenade. Goes to throw the grenade, gets down, boom.
The grenade, I went, there was one time I was cooking a grenade in my hand. And then I got shot from super far away. So my teammate Koto came and res me, but since I had the grenade in my hand, I got down, the grenade then dropped out of my chest, and
died. I sent you guys the clip in Discord that I don't think it's made into a video yet, where Rob is like, I'm gonna kill the last guy with a grenade. So yeah, he's walking around with a grenade. He's like, where are they?
I thought they were blind down.
He doesn't even clear the desk.
I thought they were lying down in that little desk, so I pulled it out, and I was like, I'm gonna run at them and kill them with this grenade in my hand. How funny would that be?
Hops on the computer.
I literally was just running around with this grenade like beside my head.
But Rob, you gotta like cherish those moments when you make people in chat laugh. Like if you're dumb, you just gotta fucking roll with it.
I guess, but
because when we were playing Among Us, I did so much stupid shit. And I was like, I feel so stupid, but I look at chat, I'm like, oh, they're laughing.
All my moves were gamer moves. I had so many dumb plays too.
One of the best moments of that stream was just when. So you've played it.
Right? I haven't played yet.
Oh,
that'll be my first game tomorrow.
I've seen it played. I haven't played it.
Okay, so like one of the emergencies you can do is like the reactor, and then you need two people to go to the reactor on opposite ends, and like each have to scan their hands. And this was like one of the first times we were playing, and I walk in and Danielle's there. So I scan my hand, she scans hers, and we're good. And I was like, oh,
we're Gucci.
Danielle like scanned it. She's good. Like I can trust her. Because I was like, only good people can do this. And then we're walking together, and then I hadn't looked over at chat yet. I was like, wait, can like bad people do that? I don't know for sure. I was like, maybe she is an imposter. And I just don't know. And I look over at chat and they're all like, yes, 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 an imposter can do that. I look back over and Daniel just fucking stabbed me in the back. Are you fucked?
The best thing was like, Daniel's like, yeah, I always do that play. And then like the next game does that exact play. We get to a thing, there's one dead body. And everyone's just like, well, we bet you it's Danielle. Like, no, nothing to base this off. And then we vote her out. She was an imposter and got so, not mad, but like, it was funny.
Like, doggo mad. Like, what the heck? You shouldn't have been able to figure that out.
I'm pretty hyped to try it. I thought it was an FPS until like last week.
Oh, it's fucking great. That could be kind of sick.
Friday stream was probably like the most fun I've had playing a game in a long time.
Yeah, it was so good.
It was up there with like Halo when we played for the first time, the custom games.
Mm-hmm. It's like, yeah, it's just like, it's like a series of mini games. It's like that Alien game from Jackbox, right? Sort of.
Yes.
In the same sense.
The same premise. Or like, actually, no, you weren't there for Deceit.
Pretty much, it's like there's 10 people. Two of them are bad. You're running around. You don't want these people to kill you. You have objectives, and you're trying to figure out who the bad people are.
And like, you get clues from doing these games.
You don't get clues. No. You just like, you find a dead body eventually, and you're like, okay, who was around that person?
And then it's just a matter of being like, okay, Rob, what's your story? Yeah. Where were you? And then someone else will be like, I was over there. I didn't see Rob at all.
Yeah. And then like, there's like security cameras, so like there's certain spots that you can sit at a console and see. There's like certain spots. That one is sweet where there's like, if you walk past this, it tells you like, Varsity walked north through this corridor. Like there's little sensors and spots. Yeah. Like that stuff's sick.
I'm excited to try it.
And I assume like when you die, you just deafen or something?
So in between every round, everyone's deafened or mute. Sorry, everyone's muted.
Like you're not allowed to talk while you're doing stuff.
Like, you're not
in a Discord call?
Yeah, so everyone mutes themselves. And then as soon as there's a discussion, so as soon as you find a body, you unmute and everyone can talk. But as soon as that goes away, muted again. Yeah.
Is it like integrated with Discord or something?
No, you have to do it yourself. Oh. But they...
DIY, baby!
Yeah. It's sweet.
Ew. This is making my face edge too. Kind of getting unfortunate. Whatever.
Rob just got COVID.
Yeah.
A bad COVID. Sorry, guys.
What? Fuck.
But does anyone remember what time we started at, by the way?
Yeah, I got you. I've been timing it from now on for things like this. We got...
It was like 7:15, I think, wasn't it?
We got...
I just can't remember because Rob promised that he would be here at 6:45.
And yeah,
I was busy eating tuna.
Speaking of that, 6:30 fucking sharp tomorrow.
Yes.
Thank you.
I'll get my workout in.
6:30?
For
I've heard
7,
I've heard 6, I've heard 6:30.
Well, like,
it's 6:30.
Okay.
We'll start the first game
at
6:30.
Stop fucking making up numbers.
I've heard 9 o'clock.
We did say 10 at one point, yeah.
I might just, he closed his eyes. He couldn't see objects.
I might just... Fair. I haven't... Do you guys... Okay, I'm going to give myself a pat on the back for a sec. Okay? I went to the gym.
Can't wait to roast this. No, I'm kidding, yeah.
I went to the gym, and there's everyone there. Most people looked kind of like, you know, out of shape, blah, blah, blah. And then it's kind of skinny. They lost some of their mass. Everyone comes up to me. They're like, dude, like... You look pretty good. Like,
aww, blah, blah, blah. It's the workout video.
And I was like, dude, I'm telling you, I worked out every single day of quarantine at home with like minimal equipment, just exercise bands. So, good job, me.
And
I stayed in shape for the most part.
That's actually awesome. Though.
So that's.
I thought there was gonna be more.
No,
what do you mean, Rob?
I'm just wondering what the point of this.
I'm
that's fucking
I'm flexing
awesome
on all you guys.
What do you mean? That's awesome. Yes. Yeah.
I thought it was gonna lead into like a conversation.
Yeah.
Topic, no, man.
And he's just like,
just
I'm jacked. We can go around the table.
I'm a better person than all.
Yeah,
of
I'll go next. So I
sat on my ass in PJs. Yeah.
There was like a month and a half period where I'm like, well, I'm not doing anything.
Yeah.
Lost literally the 15 pounds it took me 6 months to gain. Mm-hmm. And I think I'm just crawling back. Like, I'm pretty close to where I was. I was telling Christian, I have the same strength as before. I can see your
forearm veins again, which is
disgusting.
Yeah. That's climbing.
We were talking about how his forearms are bigger than his biceps.
Yeah, my forearms are, like, wider than my fucking bicep right now. It's strange. Yeah,
I wouldn't say that.
But, thanks, Rob. But, don't mind
him, man. It's time to pat yourself on the back, but Rob's going to shit on you.
No, yeah. And a good way, you know? But, we'll start doing bicep curls all the time.
We were talking about that today. Like, I think I have the same strength I did before. The difference is, right now I have, like, a 15-minute window, whereas before I could do everything I was doing for like an hour. So yeah. I'm just pumped to be close.
I'm just saying, you guys got at least one of you has to come to the gym with me starting soon, man.
Again, please. I said I will actually consider it in the winter.
Yeah.
For sure.
Well, as soon as they get rid of this fucking scheduling nonsense, we can just rip it all the time.
I've been debating going back to like World or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
it's just such a good routine to be in, man, working out, even if it is rock climbing, biking.
Where's your exercising. Bike?
I tried to buy one. I tried to buy a bike.
Sure. Like, we don't make. Do you want a tricycle? Like, we don't make bikes this small anymore.
So, you went to Toys R Us.
Yeah. I spent so long Googling like what kind of bike I wanted. I'm like, I'm gonna have it for years. I'm gonna get a nice bike. Blah 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 blah.
Yes, we know.
Trying
we
to buy it in the sketchiest week. Town in all of.
I Canada. Messaged three different bike places in three different cities. They're all like, it's on back order. The generation that's exceeding it is already all pre-ordered.
Just get a Benelli.
You literally can't get it.
Like, just get a the kind okay. I have a nice one. It's called the Benelli. It's pretty cheap. Mine was like $450, I think.
No,
do it.
This guy's looking at like fucking $2,000 bikes.
Why? You don't need a $2,000 bike.
Fucking look at this kid.
I like bikes.
Yeah, he does need a $2,000.
You don't need a $2,000 bike.
No, here's the thing. My old bike was really nice.
Yeah, got stolen. We've heard this 30 times.
And I want a similar bike. I really like that bike.
For reference, Drew also bought a watch, and then within a week was like, I need a new watch.
No.
The watch where you're like, no, the strap doesn't work. Like, it's not good anymore. And you're like, I need to get a new watch.
I bought the watch knowing I was going to replace the strap, and I replaced the strap.
His watch That's collection is worth more than you and me combined.
How many watches do you have?
Four? Five? Five?
Fuck.
Yeah,
I don't know a single watch, but I
wear a watch every day, though.
I hate having shit on my wrist. I think I've said this before.
And me too,
your point, I'd rather spend more money on a bike that I know I'm going to like than buy two bikes at $500.
As Bree said,
we can make with one $500 bike last forever. My dad has the same bike since like 1996.
Shout out Bree, you'll love it. She's not a chance. So what happened to the climbing? You love that. It just died. You could find a way there. What happened to like skipping and exercising?
Oh, he loved that. He bought the skipping rope and he's like, I'm going to do this every day. He did it like twice and never did it again.
Price.
I almost dragged this guy into working out during quarantine. Almost. And then he left my grasp.
I'd love to go climbing again.
Then go climb.
When?
There's tons of opportunities there.
The 8 o'clock slot.
The problem is you're going back and climbing when there's three people there.
I'm not saying climb.
That sounds awesome. I don't want to go when it's packed.
The 8 o'clock slot has only like five people signed up.
Even the busiest time.
Really?
Yeah.
Why is no one going back?
Well, it just depends on the day. It truly does. Even the busiest time I've seen is like 25 people in a place that used to hold like 100.
And it's this not is bad. A guy who goes to like a
fucking bar mitzvah.
A branch. Oh yeah, goes to weddings, goes to
I go to work.
And you go but like you are way more likely to get COVID at your work than going to a 25 person rock climbing gym. Because I'm more likely to get
COVID at work. I'm just going to go to both.
Yes.
Yes. You might as well cancel. Yeah,
well, I'm more likely here. I may as well go here.
It cancels it out.
Yeah.
It's simple math.
This is how America works.
I'm just saying, at that point, if you're so worried about it, you might as well just tell your work that you're not comfortable working and work from home.
There's a lot of measures in place. If it was like everyone on the wall has to wear a mask, I'd be like, all right, cool.
There's a lot of measures in place here. You don't just walk in and climb anymore.
I just don't understand why at any point they're like, when you're doing this activity, you can take your mask off.
Because it's an exercise. It's the same as good life. As soon as you're doing your activity,
like 6 feet, you can take your mask off, is what they say.
But again, you're on the wall.
But like no one really follows that.
What do you mean?
Like
they all wear it?
No, and like, I leave mine on for the most part, but when I get to my little area, I take it off. But like if you just looked around the gym on an average day, you'd think there's nothing different. Although they do have like sanitized spots like every.
Mm-hmm. And you have to clean shit out of everything.
Yeah, yeah, you have to clean everything before and after, or else they kick you out.
You did before too.
Drew.
Really?
I've seen guys get kicked out. They're like, you have like, they have, sometimes we'll give you a warning if you're a regular, but
yeah.
I was there on like Saturday this weekend. And there was some guy kind of being a dick about it. And like everyone noticed that he wasn't cleaning anything.
Yeah.
And then he kind of gave off the look of like someone who doesn't give a shit. And then they just came up and talked to him and said, hey, like, you're endangering everyone else by not cleaning. You got to go. This is, and then they just kicked him out.
I didn't think they'd actually do it. Yeah. Rage?
Like, I didn't see like the end of it, but he looked pretty. He's like, he's like, wait, I have to leave right now. And they're like, yes. Yeah. And then I put my earphones in.
Rob's like, fuck. Yeah.
I just want to throw in, oh, Drew, God. You're like, oh, the branch. The branch has so many measures in place.
Yes.
How often do you come here being like, this fucking bitch customer who came into work today didn't have a mask on. This person didn't have a mask on. They were complaining.
No, she shat on my desk.
She
came in. I had to clean it.
As soon as they walk in,
they all put one on, though. You say, hey, sir, it doesn't matter. Can you please put on a mask?
At that point, it's already compromised.
The deed is done.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is. What do you mean? The whole point of the mask is that if they breathe out, it's in the air, and then it's there.
So if they walk in without a mask. There's a
difference between someone breathing out into the air once and 200 times while they're in the branch. The
disease is gone. Like, three breaths, it's everywhere.
Yeah, it's out there. It's too late. The area's been compromised.
You having a conversation with them.
The mission's been compromised.
Okay, for reference.
Okay,
No.
You're ganging up on me and not listening to anything I'm saying.
I have the perfect analogy.
So do I.
I bring in a balloon filled with helium.
Okay.
I let go and open it for 1 second.
A bunch of Italians in here.
And I close it. You're telling me there's not a single drop of helium in the entire area.
That's not what I'm saying at all. I'm saying if someone comes in not knowing if they're infected or not, and they breathe out into the air once versus 200 times, it's way more likely that it's going to be in
200 times.
Because if they wear a mask for the whole time they're in the branch or none of the time they're in the branch, if someone comes in without a mask and I say, can you please put on a mask? One says no, walks in, breathes all through the air the whole time. Other says yes, puts on a mask,
Drew,
and then they're just...
You gotta simmer.
You're not making any sense.
Is someone hyperventilating? Like, I take like three breaths, and I'm good.
This guy walks in, you see, put a mask on?
She's like,
quick, I'm trying to infect everyone I can.
I'll show you.
But the point still stands. The area is compromised.
No, it's...
Yes, it is.
It's not about the area being compromised.
It's like secure area.
It's about the likelihood of someone not knowing they're infected infecting the area.
But if they are infected and they breathe once,
I'm actually curious. So when someone walks up, do they stand there and like not touch anything?
What do you mean?
Like, do they just stand on the other side of the desk, not touch anything?
They
just touch
the pin pad.
And I assume you clean that. But like, do you clean the tables and stuff? Do you still have the chairs?
Yeah, we have chairs. But we don't sit in them.
But others do.
Well, like, that's the risk you're taking by going out into the world right now.
Could you expand on that?
What do you mean?
That's the risk you're taking going out into the world right now.
This guy.
But everyone has masks on when they come in. Instead of being a dick, just say what you're trying to say.
You're literally like, oh yeah, like that's just the risk you take.
Yeah,
they
no
go
problem.
Fucking rock climbing. It's just the risk you take.
I don't want to take the risk of being in the same area as people that are told they're not allowed or they're allowed to not wear masks.
They have to wear a mask.
Except when you're on the wall, which is 90% of the time you're going rock climbing.
Question. It's like, are you forced to sanitize and wash your hands like the customer when they walk in?
No, but I do.
But the customer's not.
Actually, most do.
Yeah, it's still
hand sanitizers.
Around. When I walk in, I do the same. I sanitize my hands. Mm-hmm. I wash my hands.
I use like I do, if
but
it's
there's
there.
People who don't.
Yes,
and they touch things.
Well,
correct.
Here's the thing. Okay, person A.
Don't you dare.
Person A is infected with some virus.
Okay.
Fuck COVID. Doesn't matter. They have some.
They
virus.
Have chicken pox. Yes.
Herpes.
They're wearing a mask. It's all contained within their mask. Then they go to the holds. They're breathing up on the holds the whole time, and then they put
I
their mask
I thought you were
talking
about the
banks.
So yeah, like,
because person B comes along, touches all those holds, touches all the next holds. All of a sudden, it's spread all around. If they just kept their mask on, it's way less likely that there's any virus on any of those holds
so
and that it's getting spread.
Because, yes, when you breathe, it only infects what's in this little box right in front of you,
those
holds.
It's more likely to infect what's right in front of you than what's 100 feet down on the other side of the room.
That's definitely how it works. I'm not saying 100 feet. But I think it could definitely spread from this side of your booth to that side of your booth.
but we have plastic.
Wow. Plastic goes from the floor all the way to the ceiling with complete seals around
it. It's like 4 feet of plastic that's like 3 feet wide.
Wow.
It's like Blackbeard Shield, but on steroids.
Yeah, it is.
It's the same thing they
have. Trying to rob the bank now.
It's the same thing they have in grocery stores.
I don't think grocery stores are safe.
Yeah, I wouldn't.
Neither do I, but they're safer than not wearing a mask climbing out of a fucking
wall. Let me hear it. You go grocery shopping.
Yes.
Can you say the line?
What?
It's a risk you have to take.
In this world.
You're all fucking dumb.
Yeah, we're just fucking with you. I kind of agree.
No, you're fucking stupid.
It makes perfect sense.
I get it. It just circles back to the whole blurred lines conversation. Mm-hmm.
You go, but like, if your blurred lines err on the side of caution in more necessary
areas. In like certain situations, sure.
But it's like, is rock climbing a necessity?
No, listen, but is a wedding a necessity?
There's only one per couple.
Is the bar mitzvah a necessity?
Is the bar mitzvah?
Been to a fucking bar mitzvah.
I actually went to one for a second. I was like, when the fuck did this happen?
No. I just don't understand. It doesn't make any sense to me how, like, you're going to be breathing heavier, you're sweating, which it can also be contained in.
It would be crazy. It's like, if it was like a hot day, you had outside wedding, you're breathing a bit heavy because you're in a suit. And,
whatever. What it, oh, not
my
in
bad,
a suit.
My bad.
And the priest that's on your bubble is standing next to you and chatting.
Yeah, stroking you. Wait, what?
I'm never playing Catan again.
Oh, we lost.
I just don't understand the whole point. Like, the one time in rock climbing you should be wearing a mask, you're like, don't worry about it. The one time you should be wearing a mask working out, don't worry about it.
Mm-hmm.
And then the freaking Nelk boys and stuff, they're like, yeah, reopen all the gyms, fuck this. They're like, Jesus.
Thought you'd love
them. I don't know. I think we need the gyms.
I haven't watched a single video since they started on the whole, like, not giving a shit about
I'm
the
proud
pandemic.
Of you. You're not like Rob.
I don't watch Nelk just because of...
No, but like, you still watch like Keemstar and stuff.
Even I haven't watched a Keemstar video in over a month.
I'm proud of you. If I could...
But I don't know. Maybe that his content just turned like... It was toxic to begin with.
I think we just started roasting. Yeah.
But like, it just turned into straight up like... I don't even know how to display it. Just like, yeah,
garbage.
That literally always was that.
Well, like the Pokimane shit was like, I'm not a Pokimane simp. Well, I guess I'm gonna sound like a simp.
Let's be honest. Yeah.
Keemstar and Leafy like bullied Pokimane to the point of me actually empathizing with Pokimane over Keemstar, and I was just like, what?
Oh, can we talk about that? Leafy got banned.
Crazy.
And then he's saying how bullshit it is, and Keemstar is like trying to back him.
Well, it's just like
ride or die.
Why did he get banned?
Because he made, well, apparently it was 12?
Five videos in a row.
I heard it was 10 or like,
well,
12.
All of his videos were trolled to some degree, but five in a row were directly just roasting Pokimane for random
and
shit.
And like bullying her viewers and like calling people out by name.
And
stuff.
He was apparently, like, he would go through her tweets and like read off people tweeting back and like, you're a simp, you're a fucking loser, you've never had sex before.
Crazy is, isn't that like what blew him up?
Yeah. Yes.
Way back in the, isn't that crazy? Like that was like.
Well, like now we have cancel culture and like society has a lot of different norms. And
to be honest, when he made his like little comeback, I'm surprised he survived.
Well, like I knew he wouldn't last too long based on the content he makes now. Like, dude, cancel culture. Once that like, you have one thing against you, you're done.
Mm-hmm. Not always. There's been a few redemptions.
I don't know, Sir John McDonald.
Pro Jared.
He's who's toast. That?
The guy who like.
Is that the guy who worked at Subway?
No, their name Jared is just always ruined for me because of that.
Yeah, he got exposed and people were like, oh, he's like messaging underage girls, like sexting them, all this and this. His wife came out and was just like, I'm leaving him because he cheated on me.
Shout out to
and then he like serious. He posted something being like, oh, we are like taking a break or divorcing, I don't want to like talk too much about it. And then she was like retweeting it being like, this fucking scumbag cheated on me and all this stuff and all this drama.
Damn.
And then he just went silent for like 4 months and he made a video, came back, and like he had the receipts for everything.
Shit.
He had all of the logs for all the messages, and he's every single person he messaged was like, are you over 18? And they'd be like, yes. And he asked for some proof and like they'd move on from there. It was all consensual. All the screenshots that were shown were like all cropped to make it look like he was a bad guy. He had like receipts of him and his wife being in an open marriage and her being with other guys and him being with other girls, and they were both fine with it.
That's fucked.
And like he basically just fucking turned
like
it all around.
Shit.
Yeah. It's like Justin Bieber.
You said there this was, last week.
Yeah, well, it's the same thing though.
What would Justin Bieber do? He has an open relationship?
No, he had someone called him out and he's like, yeah, no, I was literally not there. Yeah.
He was like, was that? Oh, I thought you were talking about just like when he was younger
someone,
and
was
not. Was
it like a sexual assault?
Yeah. Someone was like, at like this one event, like Justin Bieber
and
like sexually assaulted me, lured me in, whatever.
He literally just like, Here's the pictures of the night. Here's everything I was doing. I wasn't there.
But yeah. he let the like internet roast him for like 48 hours.
And then boom.
And then he came back with like all this proof. He messaged like Selena Gomez because they used to date at the time. And she like put a thing. He's like, Justin was with me that night.
And
like,
then and then he
literally just no and, way this could happen.
And then he sued.
Yeah. I hope so.
No, Connors, he did.
Hopefully. Yeah. That kind of shit can ruin your life. It has people ruin people's lives.
He was ready.
Yeah, well, he was geared up.
Geared up and ready to go.
It's always like, you always want to like empathize with the person making the accusations.
It's so hard.
But now it's like, there's been so many cases where it's been, you know, it's
guilty until proven innocent.
Yeah, it's like, the internet's just like Twitter and like the mob is so quick to just, we need someone to cancel and be mad at. We need like the next person in line.
SJM got beheaded the other day.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, the fucking statue?
Yeah.
There've been a few cases of that on like Twitch recently, especially with like the whole Me Too movement.
Yeah.
And a lot of cases for like, as far as we know, have been legit, mm-hmm. but there've been like a few cases that have been popping up that like just don't make any sense. Random.
That's the shitty thing is like most of them are legit. There's mm-hmm. those like couple that you're just like, oh fuck.
Yeah. Well, there's like one case.
Fucks the whole thing.
Dr. Disrespect.
Well, no one, like there wasn't an accusation or anything.
He's cheated on his life.
There's so many accusations.
But that was proven.
No. Wait, like the most recent time when he cut off the stream, people are like, oh, like he's going to jail, all this stuff.
No, but that was just speculation. No one had any proof.
It has the same, like...
We still don't know what happened, though, don't we?
No. I don't think it really has the same weight because he came back better than ever.
Yeah.
I know, but for that week where he's not making any comment or anything, those if one of those tweets got picked up with like an ounce of that could make sense.
Oh, yeah.
I guess.
But I feel like for the most part, when I was watching the Dr. Disrespect thing, most people were pretty good about it. Like even on the live stream fail subreddit, people mm-hmm. would post a tweet being like, this is what happened. And people would be like, we don't know that.
There's
literally nobody knows. No substantiated proof.
And anybody that had like the potential of knowing was just like, yeah, we know, but there's no fucking way I can ever say this.
Slash retweeted like, I know, but I don't feel comfortable sharing. Yeah, and now he just gets trolled every single time he tweets.
Yeah.
Fair.
There was a.
I'd troll him. He's kind of an asshole for that shit. But
there was a few people
Keemstar's
who did that.
Keemstar's okay?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I don't watch Keemstar anymore.
Who do you watch? Leafy?
He attacked my queen.
Idubbbz. Jesus.
Idubbbz is a fucking. Dude, that guy's a mess.
That's jokes.
I used to like his shit, but now, like, the whole, like, girlfriend has an OnlyFans and the clip of him being like, guys are going to jerk off to my girlfriend and I'm perfectly okay with that. That's just like, dude, what the fuck? You put that on the internet? You know you're going to get roasted.
I mean.
Just like me.
If they're comfortable with that
doesn't align with my values, so I find that very strange.
That was the other thing we were going to talk about.
What?
Don't have time.
Yeah, fair.
Is what?
But actually,
tune in next time.
What is it?
What were we going to talk about?
The what's her face? OnlyFans, $200.
Oh, Bella Thorne.
Yeah.
So there was so much drama. Did you guys follow it all?
Yeah, what happened?
I followed all of it, to be honest.
Basic summary for those who are
all
watching. Bella Thorne.
I paid $200 to follow it.
She's like a Disney actress, right?
And she was. But she's like really hot now because
I've seen photos. She's not that hot.
She's like, I think she's pretty hot. 6,000 piercings on her face.
Anyways.
Well, I don't like this nose one. But
anyways.
Doesn't matter.
She made an OnlyFans and said it was going to be like nudes, but then it wasn't nudes. And then she started messaging people because you can send stuff out to your fans and be like, if you pay this much, you get an extra bonus item. And she said it was like full on tapes of her having sex or something. And then it was just like lewds and she scammed them. And OnlyFans changed like all of their policies because she fucked them.
And now they're in debt.
Yeah, they're fucked.
They can't afford to pay out Bella Thorne because
everyone's charging back.
Yeah, there are so many chargebacks, and now their whole like economy is fucked. And
then chargebacks cost the company $20 each,
something like that.
Oh, really?
And now OnlyFans is being like, hey, we can't pay all of our creators
until the end of the month.
Till the end of the month,
$1.2 million in just like. Cash that they
just
need to have
just
and
pissed
didn't
out
have.
Yeah
I still can't out. Yeah like how does a company that big not have $1 million on hand
they're probably just really high
growing,
cash
yeah.
flow right coming yeah. in and out all the time so that's what if I had to guess from what I'm my minimal knowledge of how corporations work
but like I feel like at that point you like you should have a
but,
lot
but
of
like,
money on hand
they're still relatively they're probably putting a lot of it back into the company
correct. Yeah
I guess
like in servers or infrastructure whatever hiring mm-hmm.
this just shows everyone that OnlyFans probably is a shit business model if they can't afford
that,
this
yeah.
happening
mm-hmm. yeah. yeah all right so. Question of the week did you pay the $200
yes
there's only gonna be like one comment it's gonna be Rob I paid for
I
it
I did it I did it Bling's like I paid for Rob
I gifted Rob's account
but what do we want the question
I don't know we covered so much shit
today
that's
a pretty good one man
no
We covered a lot of shit today, so I'm trying to think of one topic we can build off of.
I feel like this is one of the few podcasts we've had where we only had like three or four topics and we just talked about it forever.
It was perfect.
Game of Thrones, HTV shows.
Are you a pussy when you watch scary movies and why?
Yeah, scary movies.
Yeah, do scary movies scare you? Or are you too analytical?
Or what's a really good scary movie to try and introduce people into scary movies?
Yeah, that's a good question.
Because I used to hate them and I'm okay with them now. But I can't tell you. I can't tell you what that...
Have you seen Hereditary?
Saws are so good.
Have you seen Hereditary?
No.
Fuck that movie.
See, I can't get into those movies because like I look at it, even without the whole analytical part, I'm just like, this isn't real. It's a movie.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, you're lucky then. Because I watch that shit.
Because, yeah, I can't get into it with like my friends, but...
For me, I watch it and I'm like, dude, I'm going to die. Like, I can't... I'm not going to survive.
Rob looks at his treehouse. Are the Hereditary people in there?
Fuck that movie, though.
But, yeah, what's your gateway horror movie?
Yeah. And are you scared of horror movies?
Yes.
Are you a wimp like me? Or are you a Chad like Christian? Same.
One an alpha.
Chad, and then alpha. You're in the middle somewhere.
Drew's like floating.
I'm definitely
in the
wimp side.
I got
for
blurred
sure.
lines.
He's a Bravo.
Blurred lines.
All right, perfect.
All right, bye.
Bye.